I created this custom scripture lua thread on the Bible Shoe software, and in this particular video I want to show you how you could also create a more beautiful looking custom scripture lua thread on the Bible Shoe software, even if you don't know how to make use of any graphics tool at all. Without any further ado, let's dive in. Give the video a thumbs up and let YouTube algorithm know you're happy with the content. The first thing you're going to do is to go ahead and open your web browser. And let's go over to this website known as Bootstrap. Well, go ahead, just visit the website, and you could open any of the design that is on the website. So it don't have to be this or that, just any of the design at all. It could be the portrait one or the landscape one. Let's just open this one here. Over to this one here. Remember, it could be any of the design at all. We don't need all this, we're going to be deleting all of it. Okay, delete this one, everything here, just delete everything, even the background. We don't need the background as well. Set it on transparent, and this is what we have here. Now if you open the one that is not 1920 by 1080, what you have to do to resize that, go over to the resize button here, go down till you see that here. Going to see the 1920 by 1080, click it, and it's going to resize the one you already selected. In case you the one you selected, it's not 1920 by 1080, we just resize it to 1920 by 1080. Once you're done, go ahead and click on the media here, and then move out to shapes, just bring in any of the shapes here. Yeah, then just resize this, turn it where you want it to be on. That's this. Click on it, go over to the outline here, make sure the thickness is set on 0. Then on the color here, you could just use any of the color that you want to use here. Color tab here, on the outline, set the thickness to 0, and on the color tab here, set the color to any color that you want to make use of. You want to make use of red, but also set it on red here. Just drag it up a bit, set it how you want it to look like. See how this one is looking here on the screen, and if it's too big, you could also reduce that as well. Also reduce the opacity of it. Once you're done, go ahead and download it. This is just what we need here. Even if you don't have any graphics knowledge, you should be able to do this. Go ahead and open the Bible Shoe software. Once the Bible Shoe software is up, go ahead and click on the configure tab here, and then on the configure tab, go over to background. On the background, go over to picture, configure tab, background, picture. And on the picture here, click on browse tab here, then bring in the image that you just created. Let's click on open, and this is our background here imported on the Bible Shoe software. And once you've already done this, the next thing you're going to do is click on layer. When you go back to the layout, you're going to see three tabs inside. You're going to see the layout, the reference, and also the verse. Now the purpose of all of this is just to resize the text to fit in on the background that we created using Bootstrap My Wall. We're going to start with the verse. After that, we'll go back to the reference before I show you some other settings that you also need to do as well. Now on the verse, just scroll down, you're going to see the verse just on the horizontal position. Resize this to fit in on the text, just bring it a bit to the right, a bit to the left, depending on the design that you did using the Bootstrap My Wall. We'd use the width here to just to resize it, bring it in a bit, and also the vertical position, but also use this to take it up or down depending on where you want it to be. And you can also use this here as the height to increase the overall height of the layout. Just here, just increase this a bit. And once you are done with the verse, once you fit in the box on the design that you did using Bootstrap My Wall and you're comfortable with it, go over to the reference and also do the same thing. Play around with the horizontal position on the reference to just position it where you want the whole layout to be. And also on the width here, you can also use it to increase the width of the left and also the right hand side of the template. Also the vertical position here, you could also use it to take it all the way up, also bring it down as well, just to fit in where you have your verse and also where you have in your reference. And also on the height here, just play around with it as well to increase the height and also reduce the height Now, this can vary based on the design that you have. So depending on whichever design that you did using Postema, we'll just use the configuration here just to bring it in to fit in on those places where you have the design. When you're done here, the next thing you're going to do is to go over to the aspect. In the reference aspect, you're going to see merge reference with vast text. You click on that, it merges the whole thing together for you. And how can you also adjust the color of the text that you have? For you to be able to do this, all you have to do is for you to go over to text. Now on the text here, you can choose the font you want to use. Over here, I use the Lemon. Just click on it and then you can choose any font at all that you're comfortable with. After you've selected your font, go over to the width here to also change this to bold, depending if you want it to be bold or if you want the text to be light. And then go down, you're going to see the decoration. Just put this one on none. Maximum size, you could also use this to increase the size of the text once you've done your layout. And over there on the color, you'll also play around with it to choose the color you want to use for the verse. And once you're done with the verse, click on the reference beside it. Also do the same thing on the font. Choose the font that you want to make use of. The width, make if you want it to be bold or normal. On the maximum size here, you can also increase that. And on the color, you could choose whichever color you want to use for your reference. On the text alignment, you could choose where you want the text to be on, if it's on the right hand side or the left hand side, depending on where you want it to be. And on the outline, also you could play around with the thickness if you want the text to be thick. Just leave the shadow the way it is and also the glow the way it is as well. And when you go over to the verse, you can also see do the same thing there as well. See font for Word of Christ on the verse. When you scroll down, it also sets the width of the font for Christ, what you want it to be. And then when you go over to the alignment, you also see it there horizontal. You could also put it on the center or left or right, depending on where you want it to be. And also the vertical, you could also put it on the middle or at the bottom. You can also put it at the middle so they can create that space between the reference and the verse. And when you scroll down on the outline, you could also play around with it if you want the text to have some thickness, and you could leave it the way it is. On the shadow, leave it the way it is. On the glow, also leave it the way it is. And this is what you just need. Once you're done with everything, just go back to your themes, pop in any scripture, and you will see how it's beautifully displayed on the screen. If you want to display this on VMix, all you have to do is go over the display. On the display here, make sure you tick the NDI output and also untick the display window. Okay, because we want this to display on VMix and also OBS as well. Then once you've done this, go over to the themes and tick any of the scripture here. Open the OBS software on your PC. Click on the add input here and then go over to NDI source. Click on the NDI source. Click on OK here. No BS. First name, click on that. Now you're going to see the Bible Show NDI here. Click on that as well. Click on OK. Use this and this is how it's going to display on your screen. You can see here. If you don't like the size, you want to resize it. You want to reduce the color. Okay, or you want to reduce the background rather. All you have to do is go over to the Postema World website and you can reduce the size of the image. Once you've done that, open the Bible Show software. Open the Bible Show software. Go over to Configure, Background, Image, bring in your new image. Go over to Layout and then resize the text to fit in on the new background that you've just brought in. This is how it's going to look like. You could use this. And this is how to create your own custom lower dot on Bible Show. If you also want to bring this in on VMix, same process. Let's delete this real quick. Open the VMix software. Open the VMix software. Click on the add input here. VMix. Then go over to NDI and desktop caption here. Just give some seconds for it to load. You're going to see the Bible Show NDI here. Click on OK. And that's it here on the screen. You can see how beautiful it's looking here. And one more thing to note is on your configuration and over on the layout, when you're playing around with the horizontal position, the width, the vertical position and the height, that should be based on the design that you have. So you could create a complex design. This is just a simple design for those that don't have any graphics knowledge at all and they want to still be able to use a custom background on their Bible Show software. Thank you very much. I'll see you on the next one.